The next concept is momentum or linear momentum. Now, what is the meaning of momentum? We are using this term generally. If a person is rigid, not at all moving or not at all active, so we should motivate him. In general words, we will say his momentum is very less. So like that, what about the momentum of the objects? This momentum symbol is P. So what is the definition of the momentum? Let us take a body of mass m. When an external force is applied on it, then this body, which is in rest, will start to move. When it is starting to move, whether it is a forward direction or backward direction, according to the direction of applied force, then the body will attain some velocity, let us say V. So the product of the body's mass and its velocity is called momentum. The product of the mass of body and its velocity is called its momentum. Product of the mass of the body and its velocity is called momentum. So P, nothing but momentum, is equal to mass, nothing but small m, into velocity. So therefore P is equal to mv. If a body moves in the straight line, then its momentum is called linear momentum. Or if the body is moving in a circular path, then its momentum is called angular momentum. But what we can understand is, if momentum is constant, m is proportional to 1 by v. Or v is proportional to 1 by m. That means, if velocity of the body is less for the higher mass objects, or if the mass of the body is very high, then the attaining velocity will be less. Anyway, this mv will be constant. So this mass of the body and velocity of the body, nothing but the momentum, has one different type of explanation to understand. Let us take a small body which is moving with high velocity. Or let us take a body bigger in size, which is moving in less velocity. This is small m, capital V. This is capital M, small v. Is there any change in the momentum between these two bodies? No. Why? What about the mass? What about the velocity? These two are related like this. Means the ratio between the mass and velocity should be constant in every type of motion or every type of mass and velocity. So anyway, the product, nothing but the momentum or linear momentum, will be constant. So when a higher mass moving with less velocity or a lower mass moving with high velocity has the same momentum. Like this, we can conclude the conservation of momentum in the bodies also. Now we will see the units of momentum and its dimensional formula also. So the SI unit of momentum, where P is equal to mv. The SI unit of mass is kg. The SI unit of velocity is meter second inverse, or meter per second. this will be written like this also. Kg meter per second, kg hyphen. So the SI unit of momentum is kg meter second inverse, or kg meter per second. So what about the dimensional formula of the momentum? If you are creeping a physical quantity in this type of brackets, now we are writing the dimensional formula. That is the meaning. So the dimensional formula of the mass is, dimensional symbol of the mass is capital M. Then the dimensional formula of the velocity is LT power minus 1. This is the dimensional formula of momentum of a body. This momentum and rate of its change in momentum is explained in the second law of motion.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.